Yo, what's up, guys? It's Matt here, and we're doing a little bit different format today. If you can see, I am actually live streaming recording this today. There's gonna be no editing, there's gonna be nothing, it's just gonna be straight. Discovery Plus is releasing this docuseries on Hillsong, exposing Hillsong, you know, Carl Lentz, his mistress, what the lead pastors have done, and stuff like that. And we're just gonna watch the trailer today. We're gonna see what's it about.
Have you ever heard of Hillsong Church?
Hillsong is the celebrity church, right?
Bieber, Bono, Vanessa Hudgens, Kevin Durant.
It wasn't just this Australian startup anymore. It was Justin Bieber's church.
All right, so right off the bat, they're going after the celebrities that go to the church. Because we all know Christians are held to how they act and how they represent themselves. And obviously, you know, they're going, oh, Justin Bieber's in here, Kevin Durant, Selena Gomez, all these people, they're involved in this church. And you look, they obviously show a picture of Carl Lentz there with his shirt off, you know, not really pastor-like. So you can see where they're going with this. They're just trying to get the nitty-gritty from the beginning. Let's just keep watching.
They've had over 3 billion views on YouTube.
Hillsong changed the way that many of us saw how church could be done.
I'll agree with that statement. It's not a statement I like to agree with, but a lot of the mega churches, all the bigger churches, a lot of the seeker-friendly churches try to be like that. There's many churches out there that are not like that, and that's okay too. But Hillsong definitely does have an influence from the way we worship to the way we interact. And so yeah, I'll agree with that, even though I wouldn't publicize that too much.
They're huge now. They're huge.
You can make a real change if you come to Hillsong.
This was going to be a place where I could call my home. But that clearly wasn't the case, and it almost took my life. You can run on for a
long time. All right, so it looks like there's some people who've gotten hurt by this ministry, and that's what they're probably going to be talking about. I'm not surprised that there's going to be some sort of expose on how people feel, how people have been dealt with, how people came and left. Not in the defense of Hillsong, but when you have a ministry that big, you're bound to have people who are going to get pissed off and hurt. You know, when you're a ministry that big, or and a church that big and a movement that big, it's hard to focus on what is happening with your congregation. And that's sort of a bad thing. You know, it's not a good thing. You don't know who's coming in the door. You don't know really know who's serving. It becomes more like a business and a company, you know, rather than an intimate family. And there's going to be people who come in with different beliefs, different values, and different ways of doing things. And it's just, there's going to be friction, and people are going to get hurt. Obviously, I don't know the extent of all this, but that's just my first impressions.
When we talk about Carl and purity, how could you shame me when I was so young, but you did this?
It was the most toxic thing I ever had to deal with.
Hey, girl. Hi.
Okay, so wasn't really expecting to go that deep, but I knew they were going to dive into the Carl Lentz thing, but that girl you just saw, the one before the phone, that was... I believe that's the girl that Carl Lentz was caught cheating with. But it also looks like they have some videos of Carl Lentz, like the videos that he sent her, which, man, like, they're digging deep. And I feel bad for the guy. I'm not coming here for the defense of him. You know, he did what he did, and he's going to reap what he sows. But, you know, you can really see that this documentary is digging deep. They are going to expose every little bit it's hard, you know, it's hard to defend the man. You know, when he goes out, he's taking shots with Justin Bieber, he's cheating on his wife, he's being provocative and stuff like that. It's hard to sympathize, but man, this looks like this might do a dent on the Hillsong. So just keep going through and see what else they're going to throw at it.
Sooner or later, God will cut you down.
The beliefs that they put in you go deep. They really get in your head.
This is cool church. There is a fine line between cult and culture. This is not a moral failure. It's a felonious criminal act.
All right, so I didn't think they would, but they, I guess they're talking about Brian Houston's dad. You know, I don't know if you've heard about it. Earlier years of Hillsong Church, some allegations have been brought up against the founder, I think his name's Frank Houston, about some allegations, and they're now just coming to light, saying that people knew about it and they just hid it. I'm not one to sit here and say, hey, let's expose and make people look bad just for the sake of looking bad. You know, sometimes we have to call out false preachers and all that stuff. And you know, this could be a very bad thing for Hillsong, but it could also be a very good thing for the Western church to realize, hey, we don't want to be like this. We don't want to be this type of church. These mega churches, they need to take a look at themselves and be accountable with what they're doing, you know? So this could go both ways. Like I said, this is just a documentary. It's a secular documentary. I don't really see what good's going to come out of it, because mainstream media never has anything good to say about the church. And I'm not defending Hillsong, like I said, but like, I have my own things about them, but you know, it looks like they're digging real deep. This is one of the things that, you know, I'm probably gonna watch just to watch, but I don't really want to take part in the bashing needlessly. If the guy messed up, people messed up and they got caught and they're paying their consequences for what they did, you know, then so be it. Hopefully the church learns from that, but hope not too many people beat on them, Christians at least. But let's just finish up here and see what it says.
$78 million in revenue, tax-free.
Manipulation.
All right, we almost missed that. So they're talking about the money. Anytime someone takes a jab at church, they're always going to mention the money. Obviously, this is a significantly bigger amount of money that Hillsong deals with. And where does it all go? We don't know. I don't look into Hillsong's financial statements and all that stuff, but I'm pretty sure that this is going to be talking about that too. Like I said, accountability, accountability, accountability. This will probably, you know, expose some holes that churches need to focus on so they can keep themselves accountable. But I don't know what to think of this. You know, the leaders haven't really given us much confidence lately to put our trust in that they're running things properly. So we'll just finish this off here.
Religious trauma,
systemic cover-up,
tremendous power.
Everything in your life is Hillsong.
All right, we don't need to watch any more of that. I think that's pretty much it. So, yeah, this is my first impression of this. It looks like just a bunch of secular people, people who've left the church, people who are a little bit upset, are coming and speaking out against Hillsong. Is it being done in a proper manner? I don't know. Are these people Christians? I don't know. It's very public now, so it's hard to say, is this right, is this wrong? Could this have been handled differently? Of course, with the allegations out there, they're pretty serious. They're legal now, so it's public, and you know, there could be criminal offenses being laid out, so who knows. You know, I don't really know what to think of it anymore. I'm gonna be watching. I'm gonna see what this is all about. You know, we'll talk about it as it comes out, and we'll see. Those are just my thoughts. You know, a lot of stuff is going on with the church these days, and it just seems like a lot of things are being exposed. So, and at the end of the day, people can try to tear the name apart of Christ all they want, but it's not going to succeed. The true Christians will always live fruitfully, and the true Christians will always seek out the true will of God. So this stuff, just take it with a grain of salt. Take what Discovery's saying, you know, it's a secular media. Take what they're saying with a grain of salt. Take the allegations seriously. We need to look into these and just be like, hey, okay, how can we better ourselves? How can we help these people? How can we pray for these people? But at the same time, let's not just start throwing the rocks just yet. Let's watch and see what happens. Pray for the Hillsong Church. Pray for these people, people who attend, people who go to this. You know, they're going to be affected. They're going to see this and be like, oh, that's my church. That's my pastor. And a lot of these people, I can assume they're probably weak in their faith, because Hillsong does not breed a real strong Christianity. And you might get a lot of people running and saying, hey, I don't want to be here. This, I don't be attached to this. That's fine enough, you know, but let's pray that these people do not walk away from the faith just because a few guys did some dumb things. With that said, if you guys like what I'm doing here, if this is interesting, if you want to see more of these, don't forget to subscribe. When this series actually comes out, we'll do an update. Take it easy, pray for this church, and we'll see you guys then.